Hey everyone, Shawn Clement here, Wisdom in Golf. And today, really important video. In order for you to get solid contact on the ball, I'm gonna show you how to top the ball properly. Once you understand how to top the ball properly, then you'll understand how to hit the ball solidly. You don't wanna miss this one. Stay tuned. In order for us to begin, I want to show you a very easy task that we teach our students, okay? So let me get my favorite grass whip. So if I'm cutting grass with this particular club and I'm doing it with one arm, watch how the whole arm club unit swings around my right shoulder. See that? Notice where it's bottoming out. It's bottoming out right underneath the shoulder. So the low point is here. When I bring both arms together to take my grip, the center is right here between my two clavicles, the sternal notch, and I'm just gonna swing back and through without stopping, and you're gonna see a nice blur. Can you see where the low point of that is? Now, if I'm cutting through something, notice my arms come down first, the hands come through, then the shaft, then the heel of the club, then the toe of the club. So the toe of the club only passes the heel right about here, and then comes back up and it rehinges. Now I'm going to go in the other direction. My hands come through first, then the shaft, then the heel of the club, then the toe, and it releases here. So there's a nice release there. And then there's a nice release there. This is where the peak speed is in each direction. So all I need to do is figure out where the low point of the swing is gonna be. So if I just swing back and through without stopping, just in the air, and I observe where the club is passing. See that? Notice where the bottom is, right about here. So if I lower a bit more, then I do it back and through without stopping, then I can cut grass with this club right here. Do you notice where the club is cutting the grass in relation to the ball? The ball is in the center. Watch where it cuts grass. Notice it's cutting grass in front, and notice how it's cutting grass in the back when I'm going that way. So if I raise myself a little bit higher, bring that to the ball. If I swing from here, it feels like I'm going to miss it. Yep, I see the blur right above the ball. So I go down to the equator. Now I'm going to let it swing in both directions. Watch what happens. And there we have it. The perfectly topped golf shot. Watch in slow motion here. As I'm doing, I'm walking and I'm topping balls at the same time. And notice how the hands come through first. Then from here down, it is so fast. You think you're going to miss the ball, but then, whoop, the bottom of the club cuts through the top of the ball. So it's like I'm taking my grass whip and I am hovering it above the ball, and I'm shaving a little bit off the top of the golf ball. So now if I take this and I put it on a tee, and I lower my grass whip to the grass, and I feel the sole of the club cut the grass, watch what happens. And the ball just falls to the ground, doesn't it? Isn't that cool? So I am cutting through the stem of the dandelion. I am not trying to hit the ball. Now, if you do the same thing with the sole of the club, this is my dandelion in disguise, and I'm cutting the stem of the dandelion with the sole of the club. Notice the ball's got to meet the face of the club to go into the air. Well, there you have it. So if I cut the stem of the dandelion, the ball meets the face and leaps into the air. So I'm not trying to hit the ball. I'm trying to cut grass with the sole of the club, because this is a grass cutting tool first and foremost. Then you have a nice flat surface and a nice springy face, like what they have on, you know, that flash face that they have in the Callaway clubs to really, you know, spring that ball forward. So my goal is, my eyes are between the leading edge of the club and the ball. I see the stem to be cut. If I'm over here, do one above the ball again. I see where the blur of the club is passing. That gives my brain a nice reference. So then I lower the club and I go, okay, that's going to top. I lower it some more. Oh, that feels like I'm going to cut grass. So then you let the weight of the club cut the grass. And then the ball leaps into the air. So I'm never trying to hit the ball. I'm always trying to cut the grass. So you could start with a high tee. See that? Now I'm going to have to hover the sole of the club at just the level below the ball where the tip of the tee is. And I'm letting the weight of my arm club unit cut through that. Then I could take a shorter tee, nice little knob, bring that down. See, I got just the knob showing. Then I see the sole of the club ready to cut through the knob. There it is. And then finally, when you have it on grass, if I were to poke my finger down here, see that? My whole fingernail disappears. So you've got this much grass under the ball holding the ball up. So if I just focus on letting the sole of the club cut through the grass in the direction of my target. Hear that sound? So I'm never trying to hit the ball. I'm always trying to cut through the grass into the direction I want the ball to start. That's one way of knowing your levels that's going to put the ball in the air. The other one is ball position. So many of you put the ball forward and you try to get under the ball and try to lift it. Well, if you try to do that with the grass whip, I'm going to put the grass whip here. I'm going to catch it on the way up. I'm just going to take a big slice out of the ball. The only way that I get to cut the dandelion stem, see where that is? It's got to be cutting here. So as I'm coming through, this is what happens. I'm cutting through. Notice how the weight shifts. My hands come through, then the shaft, then the heel. Cut. See how the toe of the club catches up with it? And then that comes into the finish. So you never have to think about that. A good way to feel how that works. If I were to cut some grass towards you, notice how the weight of the instrument releases me? I wouldn't do this, would I? If I'm playing baseball, there's a nice full release of that trail hand over the lead hand. And you see how that releases through? I got to let that happen. So I'm feeling that nice release in the direction of my target. So if the right hand's doing this, there's pronation. Then the left hand is doing this. There's supination. All I got to do now is let it whip through the cut and not try to steer it. I want to abandon control. So watch how accurate a human machine can be. There are my dandelions in disguise. Now I'm going to show you walking through three dandelions. If I cut my rose, see how nice and tidy those rows are? So I put each ball about a club width apart. All I'm doing is cutting my dandelions. Easy peasy. Enjoy that information. Go out and cut some grass. Enjoy the game. See you next week.